Bull Vinaka, and welcome to yet another episode of the FNU Pulse. My name is Crystal, and today we'll be talking about Indigenous women in law. And we have with us in our studio today Miss Milika Lingambalavu, who is an assistant lecturer in law at the School of Law, currently based at the College of Business, Hospitality and Tourism Studies, but soon to move to the College of Humanities, Education and Law. So Bull Vinaka, ma'am, it's so nice to have you in studio. We believe you also were the coach for our winning team. So how is that? How are you still reeling from that feeling of winning?
Well, for us, it's very, it's been a journey, an exciting one. And we're still celebrating, I guess.
Yeah. The hangover is still there from the celebration. And yes. Yeah.
Still continuing. Yes. And we've just had the celebration with the Madam Vice Chancellor last Monday. Yeah. And it's been really, really great. Yeah.
Yeah. And then we also had Miss Anuraka Mokoti come in last week on our first ever episode, and she talked about the whole journey, the future plans of the School of Law, as well as the Intertertiary Moot competition. So exciting news. Now let's talk about you. Let's talk about your journey as an Indigenous Fijian female lawyer. And what were some of the biggest challenges that you faced, and how did you manage to overcome them?
I think for me, one of the biggest challenges for me has been, and I'm not speaking on behalf of anyone else, but my own experience has been, especially during the earlier years of practice, not being taken seriously. And I mean that in terms of, like, for example, someone can come to me and ask me for legal advice, and I will give it to them. I will tell them what the law says and give them their options. And then the same person will go in and see someone else, a male colleague maybe, and he would say the same thing. And his advice would be taken over mine. But, you know, there's no restriction as to who you want to seek legal advice from. That's fine, right, in terms of lawyers. But It would seem to me that I'm not taken seriously. But how I overcame that was knowing that I'm as competent as any other lawyer. We may differ in terms of experience, but I am just as competent, and my work is what shows my competence. Yeah.
Wow. I feel like a lot of women, and especially not just in law, but all other sectors of Fiji, we usually struggle with being taken seriously. And I feel like it's not just a Fiji problem, it's a global problem. But now we have to realize that women are just as good as men. And we know our jobs, no matter what it could be. It could be engineering, could be law, could be finance. We're just as good. I mean, that's why we have our qualifications and the experience. And now talking about Indigenous Fijian women and, you know, their role in society, how has it evolved over the past few decades? And what is some things that you have seen change, like, very significantly?
Mm-hmm. So I will speak on the legal fraternity. You may have noticed over the last couple of years we have had more women, Indigenous women,
yes,
appointed to senior roles, leadership roles. We've had quite a number of Indigenous women appointed to as judicial officers, so yeah, magistrates. Also in roles like the supervisor of elections, the acting DPP role as well, and in other sectors, and in terms of in law studies, we've seen a lot of graduates who are Indigenous women as well, and who are practicing law.
I think that's very empowering. I mean, coming from somebody who is now in the School of Law pursuing my studies, before we used to see a lot of men usually in the spheres when it comes to law, politics, or diplomacy. But it's so empowering to see women, especially Indigenous women, taking up those spheres, and they're talking about things that actually matter. I was so happy to see our acting DPP be a woman. I mean, it's about time. And I was so glad. And who knows, maybe in your class right now, we have the future Tony General, who's also a lady. I mean, fingers crossed. And now we're going to talk about what you believe are some of the strategies or approaches that are crucial for young Indigenous Fijian women to succeed in today's globalized world, especially when we're talking about leadership and education. I mean, the world is, you know, just fast-paced and technology is at our fingertips. And a lot of times we often struggle with losing our own cultural identity. So what are some ways in which Indigenous women can still preserve and succeed in today's globalized world?
Yeah, I think mentoring is, or seeking out mentors is an important thing. And mentors for various aspects of life, whether it's work or, in your social life and all of that. But mentoring is very important, seeking out people who are already in that that area of success that you want to, get into, mm-hmm. The level of success, sorry. So the other thing I would say is networking, building a network, always putting yourself out there and engaging in events or attending events and mingling with people and getting to know people. Networking has been something I have been part of a lot. Building that network has helped me, and I would say that is something that we can do, especially as Indigenous women. Yeah.
So we were just talking about strategies and approaches that, we believe is crucial for young Indigenous women to succeed in today's world. And Ms. Malika, who is our assistant lecturer in law here at the School of Law, has said that it's important for us to have mentors, the right mentors, and it's important for us to network. We'll take a short break and we'll be back. And when we are back, we will talk about balancing your Indigenous heritage together with modern culture. So stay tuned.
The most anticipated event of the year is back. Fiji National University Open Day 2024. Come down and explore our cutting-edge facilities, meet our dedicated faculty, and discover how you can turn your aspirations into accomplishments. Dream it, weave it, and achieve it with FNU. Stay tuned for more details.
Vulvanaka, welcome back to the second episode of the FNU Pulse. Now, today we are talking about Indigenous women in law, and we have with us our assistant lecturer in law, Ms. Malika Lingambalavu. Now, we're talking about, before the break, about how there are some strategies and approaches that young Indigenous women can take, especially in law, to succeed in today's globalized world. She had mentioned mentoring and networking. Now, when we're talking about networking, ma'am, right now, because, we are living in this era, it's all about swiping and all of that. When we talk about networking, we're not just talking about social media, right?
No. I'm actually referring to attending events, getting to be part of events and meeting people and having conversations and building that network, face-to-face interactions, yeah.
So, knowing me, I'm super extroverted. Now, if someone is a student or a young woman who is introverted, what is a piece of advice you'd give her when it comes to networking with people in the law fraternity?
Well, I'm a little introverted myself, so
really?
Yes, it's hard to see that sometimes. But I guess the advice that I would give is that you have to build that confidence and know that the profession requires you to be out there and to be able to speak to people. So engaging in in networking activities is really important, and I would encourage it, and just to take those baby steps, but to take those steps.
Yeah, I mean, you have to begin somewhere.
Yes.
So when we talk about here at FNU, what are some ways in which we are providing mentorship to our young women in law, especially Indigenous women?
Well, I and my colleagues, we have Miss Anna Lomani and Anna Wangatambu, and our head of department, Miss Rokomokoti. We have sessions where we talk to our students, well, during classes, and we provide training and advice to students as well, and prepare them for the legal journey.
The world that's out there, yes. In the legal world.
Yes. So we give them realistic information. We make them practice ready. Mm. That's the term that we're using. And so one of the ways that we did it was through the MOOT. So how we did that was we implemented MOOT assessments in the first semester. So we got to help, got to have our students participate internally as part of the assessments. And then we were able to identify their skills. And then that was how they were chosen. And we have identified other students who have the skills that are required, and we'll be working with them to build their confidence. And MOOT is and has always been a good aspect to test those abilities. Yeah.
Mm. And in case you didn't know, most of our team this year was made of Indigenous female lawyers, law students for our intertertiary MOOT competition. So kudos to them. They did such a wonderful job. We are so proud of our young ladies. And now let's talk about finding that balance. Now, when we're talking about a balance between maintaining traditional Fijian values and embracing modernity, what is your view? And what is your advice to women who are often struggling to find that balance? You know, do I stay true to my culture and not completely evolve? Or do I evolve to work in a workplace that's super modern and completely forget about my traditional Fijian culture?
That's an interesting question. and not an easy one to discuss. But I think there is a time and place for everything. And when you're, you know, like for example, I know my place. There is a place and time and where I can speak and give an opinion and everything. So, I guess it's always important to balance everything based on circumstances. Mm. When you're in the workplace, you have an obligation to your client, to your employer, to perform the duties that you are hired to do and obligated to do. And then you have, another setting, the cultural aspect kicks in. And so I guess maintaining that identity as well is important as an Indigenous yes. woman. But also knowing that you are also a lawyer, someone, a professional, yeah. I think for me, it would be a balance, and depending on the circumstances.
All right. Now, often a lot of young women, especially Indigenous young women, struggle with, how do we say, like balancing their cultural values as well as, embracing modernity, especially those who come from rural, remote settings and then they come to FNU and they're chucked into, the urban area and then they have all sorts of pressures. Now, what is a piece of advice that has helped you or some of your friends who have been in a similar situation?
My advice would be to remember the values that are instilled in us in our homes, our churches, and our communities. So that when you're in an environment that is different or modern, you're still able to maintain that identity. And so if you're faced with a situation where you're having difficulty, your decision to maintain who you are, it comes naturally because yes. you're holding on to that identity and knowing that you're representing your family and your culture and in an environment that is diverse.
Right. So you embrace the new opportunities that's coming your way, but you stick close to your roots. So at the end of the day, it's hashtag don't forget your roots. So we will take another break and we will be back and we'll be in our final segment where we're going to talk about the advice that we have for young women who want to join the law profession. So stay tuned.
The most anticipated event of the year is back. Fiji National University Open Day 2024. Come down and explore our cutting-edge facilities, meet our dedicated faculty, and discover how you can turn your aspirations into accomplishments. Dream it, weave it, and achieve it with FNU. Stay tuned for more details.
Bulavinaka, and welcome back to yet another episode of the FNU Pulse, the Fiji National University's video podcast. Today with us in studio, we have Miss Melika Lingamalavu, who is our assistant lecturer in law at the School of Law. And we've been talking about Indigenous women in law. It's been an interesting conversation. Now, the main question a lot of you have been waiting for is this. What is a piece of advice that you wish to give to other young women, especially Indigenous women, who are wishing to pursue a career in law?
Well, law is an exciting field. Education unlocks the opportunity to a world of opportunities. So here at FNU, we provide or we have courses that are that cover a wide range of areas of law. Mm-hmm. And I would encourage anyone who's interested in studying law to enroll and experience the courses and the teaching that we have here and the support. And I would also advise those interested in joining or taking up law studies to also have a feel of the legal workforce. So if you can get have some experience out in the field, whether it's being attached to law firms or other organizations that have legal branches, I guess, legal
associations.
Yes. Yes. That would be good. And also, I mentioned earlier about mentorship. I think also finding mentors that are in the field are good to also get into
right.
and network with other law students or practicing lawyers so that you are able to build that confidence. Mm-hmm. Also, it broadens your understanding of law and the practice itself. I think if you have the interest in undertaking the course, believe that you can do it, and we are here at FNU to assist you and help you through that journey.
All right. Now, what are some of the requirements? Like, is it necessary or is it compulsory for somebody who is watching us probably in high school right now to do history or geography to become a lawyer?
No, I don't think it is. Because I mean, I'll tell you a bit about myself. I did pure science in high school, and then I became a lawyer. So yeah, anything is possible. Really, yeah.
Well, so if you are watching, or if you have someone who is, you know, pursuing pure science who's watching, and you know they'll make a great lawyer. I think you should encourage them to join the law fraternity here in the law school here at FNU. And we're so glad that we know that now, that you don't need to do geo and history to become a lawyer. So if you are thinking, oh my God, I have to cram all these dates just to become a lawyer in the future, no, honey, no. It's just English, I believe.
Yes, English is very important.
Right. So we just have to read up on a lot of things and improve our English to become good lawyers.
Yes, law requires a lot of reading and it's hard work. But if you believe that you can do it, you can.
Yeah. So if you weren't a bookworm, you have to become a bookworm. Yes. All right. So we had such an interesting conversation today about Indigenous women in law. We also talked about young women lawyers. We talked about how they can maintain that fine balance between their culture as well as modernity. We talked about mentorship, having the right mentors. We talked about networking. And we are not just talking about social media, you know, your Instagram, your TikTok. We're talking about actually networking with people in person. We also talked about if you were an introvert, how you can go about still networking with people, building the right connections so that you become an awesome lawyer in the future. And most importantly, we talked about how you can join the law school here at FNU. And if you missed it, I'm going to repeat it again. You don't need to do arts to become a lawyer. So if you're doing science, you're doing technical science or any sort of science for that matter, you can still become a lawyer. If you have the dream of doing so, please go for it. And thank you so much, Ms. Malika, for coming out here today. And we have just had such a wonderful conversation. And I think I've also been challenged, even though I'm not an Indigenous Fijian woman. I mean, the advice that you've given today is helpful to me as well. And I'm so glad that we could, you know, share this not only for the Indigenous Fijian community, but also for everyone that is watching us, not only here in Fiji, but across the Pacific and the world. So please stay tuned to the FNU Pulse, the official Fiji National University radio podcast, where we discuss issues like climate change, we're discussing Indigenous rights, we're discussing tradition and modern medicine, navigation and engineering. We have another awesome episode in line for you, so stay tuned for more updates. Until next time, Vinaka.